Today's topic is kids are back at school, so we're going to be sharing supplements and healthy swap tips for the whole family. So where we wanted to start with this is we wanted to share a little bit, like a little insight into what we do on a daily basis to boost our immune system. So the kids are back at school, as they should be back in school. Everyone's getting exposed to different things. So it's just, you know, smart for everyone. You know, we are in the office, we're exposed to people all the time as well. So it's just being smart to continuously boost your immune system. So we wanted to share some of the daily supplements that we take for our immune system.
We've been doing this for years. This isn't just because of the COVID. This is something that we've done for years. We know that this time of year is this what they call seasonal flu. And so we've been pushing these kind of scenarios to boost your immune system because your natural immune system is really, really powerful, but we've got to support it like anything else. And so it's something that we've talked about many, many years in a row with all of our clients and their kids. And our daughter and son, they're adults now, but when they were in school, we were always talking about how can we best stimulate our immune systems to make sure that they stay healthy as well.
Exactly. Yeah. So some of the things that we take on a daily basis are, and I have some to show people
couple
as well.
Couple things. So one more thing I'm just going to brag about. So for those of you who happen to be watching, I just want you to know, we practice what we preach.
Yes.
So I will say this. I'm going to pat myself on the back real quick. Been in private practice for 32, going on 33 years. I've missed one day of work in 33 years because I was sick. And it wasn't the flu. The one and two right here, we had food poisoning and we were kneeling next to each other, throwing up in the same toilet, taking turns.
Oh my God.
And Lori says, oh my gosh, we've got to get ready for work. And I looked at her and I said, I can't even stand up. I don't know how you're going to work.
Right.
That was the only day that we called off in almost 33 years.
That is so
That's
funny.
Pretty amazing.
That is, I totally forgot
Remember
about
that?
That was like, that was like 5 years
goodness.
Ago. That was way before COVID and all that.
Talk about an ab workout. Holy smokes.
But the fact that it took us both down was really pretty random. But yes. So we practice what we preach, whether it's the food, it's the exercise, it's the taking care of ourselves. We know that we can't help anybody else if we aren't doing the work ourselves.
Correct.
We know that. So, okay. We're going to be showing just a few supplements. I don't have all the supplements that we're going to talk about, but we are going to show a few of them. And just for anyone that's curious, they are available to be ordered online on Fullscript. And I actually have that link on above, below, wherever you're looking. So this is called Biodemulsion Forte. This is our vitamin D that Dr. Rappe recommends because of its high absorption rate.
Amazing product. Just everybody know, we use it because of its absorbability, number one. Number two, this little bottle right here, this little bottle, if you took 5 drops, would last 5.5 months. So
right.
You're thinking, well, 5 drops, there can't be much in there. Each drop is 2,000 IUs. So research that came out of Israel, and both, by the way, if you don't know it, Israel is pumping out the research on the COVID.
Yeah.
They did some stuff, their research, and they came out with back, I'm guessing it was about 10 months ago, because there was a lot of poo-pooing in the media about supplements not being able to stimulate your immune system, yada, yada. There were countries around the globe that were using vitamin D and zinc to help with COVID people. They found the vast majority of people that were hospitalized with COVID were vitamin D deficient, and the study that came out from Israel was that 2,000 IUs of vitamin D a day would reduce your risk of COVID by 25%.
Amazing.
Amazing.
Yeah.
And it's very inexpensive. So I will just say this. Families, the adults, I would suggest all adults right now should be taking 5 drops every day.
Every day, yes.
Kids could take 1 drop.
Yeah.
But this will help supercharge your immune system. It's an absolute must.
Yeah, very, very right important. Yeah, like Dr. Abby said, we were taking it before COVID, and we obviously upped our game with this. And yes, thank you, Nicole. I know it is the best.
Absolutely incredible.
Vitamin D. So Dr. Abby mentioned, can you see that? Zinc. So zinc is another product that we're taking right now to boost our immune right. system as well, with the research has been showing.
Research is showing, again, zinc is a big factor with regards to supercharging your immune system. Now, there are situations where we use zinc in the office with individuals that have high ferritin, which is iron stored up. Too much iron storage, high ferritin levels can really be dangerous, and over a long period of time can damage kidneys and other organ systems in the body. Nice. So we use zinc as a chelation agent to pull that extra iron out of the body in those scenarios. So it has a dual purpose with regards to those individuals. But just for the average person, you're gonna take, based on the person, we're dealing with an adult, I might prescribe two of these tablets a day. But for kids, we have another one that's a smaller quantity of zinc in it that the kids could take one a day.
Yes, yeah.
And along with their vitamin D.
Yeah, when you go in full script, there's also kid options for yes. some of the supplements Correct. As well. And it's something you can always contact us and we can help you to see
sure.
what you need.
Absolutely.
And so vitamin C is another one that we're taking. We've really upped our game on. I have this one, Bioimmunizyme Forte. So this is an immune booster that I know I personally have been taking for years, probably 10, 12 years with Crohn's disease. For whatever reason, my intestines like to hold on to a little bit of inflammation. And so this has been so incredibly helpful. And this, it's not a multivitamin, but it has lots of the different
It's got a tremendous amount of multivitamins. There's a lot of stuff in it. It's a great
yeah.
product as well. I use it as well.
Can you see
it? I don't take it every day. It depends on what my activity levels are and whatnot. But it's an amazing product as well.
Yeah, so those are really good. We do take other supplements. This is just to kind of concentrate on what we take for to boost our immune system.
Right.
And I'll talk a little bit kind of at the end after we talk about the supplements about what we can do for you as well. I wanted to bring a couple of the things that I do for extra support. So let's say I might wake up tiny, scratchy throat, maybe a little bit of a runny nose. I really like these products. And again, these are things that we use before COVID, this not just during COVID, but these wellness drops. And you can buy these on our full script. If you're local, you can get it at Sprouts as well. This is phenomenal for literally, if you just have the common cold, because there is still the common cold out there, and common cold little symptoms, and you take some of these drops, the symptoms are just gone. It's pretty amazing, this wellness.
It's got elderberry, echinacea, all this amazing stuff in there. So
yeah.
it's really, really helpful. And again, it's kid-friendly. It's kid-friendly.
Yes,
so.
It is kid-friendly. Another one of my favorites is Manuka honey. I don't know if you guys are familiar with Manuka honey. This is just a random one that I bought on Amazon. I have no affiliation with them or anything. Manuka honey is an absolute phenomenal product. It's a natural antibiotic. I have literally seen where people put it on their skin and it heals wounds. It's amazing. But what I like to do, if I ever feel anything in my throat, I do a spoonful of this Manuka honey, and there's different UMFs and different kind of potency levels. So this is just one of those little
tips. Has antibiotic properties, antiviral properties. It's a really wonderful tool.
Yeah.
It's not just a treat. You take mm-hmm. a teaspoonful of it and lick it up. That's not what it's for. Don't use it for that.
Right.
Yeah, don't do that.
No.
Specific for issues.
Yeah, and this, again, we're very much about preventative, getting on top of things, and so we are really big on red flags. I'm talking the tiniest little dry throat, drinking extra water, have that, you know, warm water with some lemon and some honey is good, but this will actually do like a teaspoon of it directly.
Right.
It's amazing. I love this tea. And I actually drink it every day at lunch. Can you guys see that it has some echinacea in it? This I get at Sprouts, and I just love the taste of it at this point. And so
great stuff.
If it can help as well, why not? So we're all about preventative stuff. So again, this is for time-wise, we're just kind of touching on little things that we do on a daily basis. So again, the idea is that the kids are going back in school, they're exposed to more, which means they bring it home and they're exposing you, the grandparents, everybody. So let's just kind of get ahead of symptoms. The other thing with supplements, before I go on to healthy tips, was to talk a little bit about some brain supplements. I know you wanted to mention a few.
Well, you know, the brain is really an amazing organ in the body, right? It's our computer. It's our hard drive, really. It stores information, and we retrieve the information, utilize it every single day, all day long. So for the brain to function normally, we have to have appropriate cholesterol levels, and I don't mean low. For those of you who think, oh, I've got super low cholesterol, I'm gonna pat myself on the back. Well, guess what? There was a study that was done at Harvard University, and they found that people with low cholesterol die sooner than people with high cholesterol.
Uh-oh.
In addition to that, when they did the studies on statin drugs, it was called the Farmingham studies, they found that low cholesterol actually starts the onset of dementia. When they put people into a low cholesterol state, they develop brain cognitive dysfunction and dementias. So we want to make sure that we keep our cholesterol levels at a reasonable level, mm-hmm. okay? If we get too low as well, we don't manufacture sex hormones. And that doesn't mean the activity, that means estrogens, testosterones, progesterones, okay? So it's really important. But your brain really thrives on fat. So we wanna make sure that we get the good fats that we can. There are the number one fats that we're talking about, the DHA and the EPA. You can't get those from vegetables. It has to go through a conversion process in order for it to work in your brain. So we have some supplements that we think are really wonderful that you can use to help supplement to make sure that your brain is functioning normally.
Okay.
Fabulous stuff.
Yeah, so Biomega, right? DHA is one. Phosphatidylserine.
Phosphatidylserine is an amazing product for us people as we've gotten older. Another study, I believe it was out of Israel, that showed that a very specific amount of phosphatidylserine 3 times a day was able to improve the cognitive skills of the individuals in the study group, whether it was reaction, memory recall, those kind of things. So it's an amazing supplement. It's not cheap, but you know, how much are you willing to pay for maintaining your brain function?
Brain,
you know,
function is important.
Exactly.
that goes high on my list, right, of things that are important.
Exactly.
So we mentioned a few supplements here. Most of what I mentioned are available on our website on FullScript, but we also want to recommend that, you know, the number one thing to do is to test. I know every week we talk about this, but it really is a foundation, right, for everything.
Everything.
You should get your blood work done because we should really see what's going on with you right now. What do you need?
So we see this a lot. Somebody will come into the office and they'll have a sheet of paper with an entire sheet, maybe 2 columns of supplements. And so what happened was they heard somebody in their little group of friends said, well, I was told by my niece's boyfriend who's taking a nutrition class, right, that we should be taking this and I should be taking that. And I read an article here and I read an article there. And Dr. McCullough said this and Dr. Hyman said that. And next thing you know, you've got this gigantic list of supplements that you're, right, taking just because someone said you should probably take that.
Right.
Don't do that with what we're talking about. These are supplements that we use in very specific scenarios. We prefer scientifically based blood testing in order for us to determine, and that's my expertise, what exactly should you get? What should I prescribe you? What's missing that your body wants or needs?
Right.
Doing it from a scientific basis. We're not wasting our money on a bunch of stuff that we don't really need.
Right.
So it's really important.
It is important. So that's the part of the supplements we wanted to talk about.
I wanted
to jump in a little bit and talk about some healthy swaps
and snacks.
Things for the family. This is for family. This is for kids. It really is for everybody. The first things that I want to talk about is making sure to increase your kids' protein levels, their hydration levels, and then we're going to talk about decreasing their sugar. So we're going to give real examples. So what I wanted to do, this is a protein powder that I personally use, and you can find it on FullScript. There are other protein powders as well. We love protein powders. Guess what? Kids love protein powders as well. It's one of the easiest ways to get extra protein for your kids. We recommend it for adults, but what a great way to make it as if for the kids, oh my gosh, it's like you're getting this incredible milkshake in the morning. So if you try to take away the waffles,
Fruit Loops,
Cocoa
Puffs,
cereal, and all those really high in sugar and high in toxins and preservatives.
Yeah, terrible.
And get them started with protein shake. Yeah. And get them involved. Have them add lots of fun things. Almond milk in there is really yummy. They can add fruit. They can add so many yummy things. The other thing too is don't be afraid to add some extra cocoa powder. This is one of my favorite ones from one of our local stores here. Make it chocolatey. For me, everything that's chocolatey is so much better.
And I think too, it's important is to reduce the volume of liquid used in order to get the protein powder. I like to have extra protein in there, but reduce the volume of liquid so they're not struggling to drink the entire shake. Or they drank this entire shake, 24 ounces, and they're going to school, and it's like they just had a Thanksgiving meal, and they're going to have a real problem, okay? It's uncomfortable. Right. Reduce the amount of liquid so that it's a reasonable volume that they can drink in the morning before school.
Right, so it's not this big thing.
It's not
and
this.
We recommend this for adults, too. Yeah. I add just a little. Now, if you want it thicker, you can make it thicker. And here's a little tip, too, is you can put that in the freezer. Right. And when they come home from school and you're looking for a snack, it's almost like shaved ice at that point. It's fun. It is cold. They're going to enjoy it. Right. And it's a great way to sneak some extra protein in there.
In addition to that, in the mornings, not to interrupt, that was really good stuff we're giving you guys, is that you can also add a quarter of a teaspoon, an eighth of a teaspoon of MCT oil.
Right.
So they get that little bit of extra fat. Remember, good fats don't make us fat, right?
Right.
McDonald's French fries in excess make us fat, okay? But not good fats. And some MCT oil in there, they won't even know that it's in there. You'll know it, and it'll be good for them.
Yeah, the healthy fats, you can do the MCT oil is great. You don't cook with it, but you definitely put it in a shake. You can add some avocado. You can sneak that in there. Almond butter is a good healthy fat as well. So definitely focus on increasing that protein.
Proteins.
And then hydration. Increase their water intake. Yeah. Really, really important to do that. Yeah. Replace the sugary drinks with just a nice cold glass of water. They want a splash of lemon in there. If you want to infuse it with some fruit, there's so many really cool infusers as well.
You can do that.
Yeah. And so
remember, protein at this age is important. They're growing. Your kids are growing.
Right.
The building blocks of their bodies are protein, not carbohydrates.
Right.
Essential amino acids mean protein. There's no such thing as an essential carbohydrate. So making sure that they're getting their protein intake up, it's really important.
Yeah, and some things you can do for snacks. Some things that we really like is if you buy the boar's head sliced meat, and you can take like a cheese stick, you can take some cooked veggies, you can do, you know what your kids like, what they don't like, but you can wrap those up, even just wrap it up on its own, and those make a quick, easy snack for after school, something really good for their lunches as well. So also, I want to talk about the snacks. For those of you who follow us, you know that I love Simple Mills products. Can you guys see that little reflection?
Simple Mills, great company.
So these are double chocolate almond flour cookies. Oh my gosh, they're amazing.
Dangerous.
Amazing. So Simple Mills has crackers. I only have the almond flour crackers right now, but they're very dangerous.
They're dangerous.
They have chocolate. They have all different flavors. And what I like about these is that you can now replace their crackers or cookies with a healthier option.
Right.
Which is helping your kids decrease their sugar when you are in control of what they're eating, because you know they're getting sugar at school and other places.
Right.
But if you can make home where they can increase their protein, increase their fats, get little healthier snacks that taste amazing, okay?
Right.
Here's another trick. You want to hear another tip?
Let's hear another tip.
Okay. So yes, my kids are all grown up, but I do have a lot of tips because I raised those kids and I was eating healthy and trying to find substitutes. There was no Simple Mills back then. I was making everything on my own. So what you do is you get your kids involved. So when you go to the store and you go into the cookie section, so you can say, okay, you're not gonna look at the whole list of cookies and say, pick one. You'll pull a couple out, like maybe a couple of the Simple Mills, and say, pick from these. Which one do you want? I can guarantee you when the kids pick and are involved, they will choose it. They will eat it. It's the same thing with dinner. Have them help you pick a recipe. Have them help you cut things. Kids love to be involved in all of that. And I'm a huge believer in family dinners and coming together mealtime. We did that with our family.
We had dinner together every single night.
Two working parents. Our daughter was in dance every night. Our son was in soccer or golf every night. But we made sure to come together as a family. And we still do that now. And they're in their late 20s. And so I really pride on that. So that's a really big tip. The other thing for decreasing sugar, again, these are little tips that you can do at home without the kids even knowing that you're decreasing their sugar, right? So I have here this Primal Kitchen barbecue sauce. If you can replace the ketchups, the sauces, because kids love to dip things, right? You can make your breaded chicken in the almond flour, and then you can dip it in like a barbecue sauce that doesn't have added sugars, doesn't have the toxins, doesn't have the preservatives. Think of what you're doing for the kids. So there's lots of little tips. It's just a matter of you taking the time, going to the stores. A lot of these things you can even order online right now, but get your kids involved, make it a family affair, and remember, they're watching what you're eating. So if you do this, they'll do that too. Right. And I just thought of this for like a fun little treat are things like chia seed pudding. Love that. And you can find lots of recipes online and Google them and all that. I just wanted to plant a few little seeds of packing the kids' lunch, what to do when they come home from school, because everybody is hungry. So be prepared, because you know they're gonna be hungry.
Right.
So, and in that morning protein, just imagine you are feeding them protein, not just empty carbs, and just think of the brain boost and everything you're gonna do for them during the day. So these are just little things that you can do. And make it a whole family affair. Make it fun.
Make it fun.
We love to cook. We love to eat. So we're always talking about food. We're always trying to make it a lot of fun.
And I like the reward system too. You know, at some point down the road, your kids are going to grow up and they need to understand that I need to earn my reward, whether it's a fancy car, a nice house, new clothes, brand new shoes, going out to dinner. Those things, I like to put them in a perspective of I earn those things, and it really is important to start when they're young. So set up a reward system. A lot of parents, you know, do something special for their kids when they do good in school. Well, let's take that and expand it into their eating habits. You will literally change their life in the long term, reducing their risk of disease in young adult and adulthood big time.
Challenge them to try something new. I know veggies is always a thing, but I love what Dr. Appiah is saying and almost having a reward system. you know, if you try two new veggies this week, you know, this will happen. If you try...
Get an extra cookie.
Yeah, two
Get your homework done.
Yeah, you know.
All of that stuff.
Yeah, there's a
Pick
lot of...
Pick up your room, make your bed, walk the dog. I mean, you can use it as a great tool, and it really teaches the foundational aspect of life in adulthood. We still do that. We have a reward system where if I'm a good boy all week long, right? Right? I've got an accountability partner that says, you know what? You've done a great job. You did a great job in the office.
Right.
You made the bed. Whatever it is, then I get a reward at the end of the week. Whether it's on Saturday, maybe I get something to eat that I normally wouldn't eat. Whatever it looks like. But it's a way for us to continue to move in the right direction. And you can do it with your kids. We did it with ours.
Yeah.
And I got to say, my kids, they're absolutely amazing. I'm so blessed. My daughter, my son, we're so blessed.
Very, very blessed. And it, as parents and grandparents, we're the role models. And so if you have different expectations of yourself, different expectations of the family, you'd be amazed at, you know, what you guys can do together. But it's also about balance. You know, what's nice is if you can kind of control what they're eating at home so that when they do go out and they go to friends' places and they're having a pizza and a soda, but they don't have that stuff at home,
right. It's
not the end of the world.
Right.
So it's all about balance and having that awareness that we want to increase their hydration, increase their protein, and really try to decrease their sugar. So those
cut it out.
Yeah, and
the
so
the root of all disease.
The number one
abused drug on the planet is sugar.
Yes.
Your brain doesn't know the difference between that and a lot of other chemicals. And there's lots of research behind that. It triggers the hippocampus, the addiction center of the brain. That's why when we work with people, when they get off of sugar, and they'll say, oh, I had some sugar, and their eyes get all lit up, and they're like, they don't realize what they used to do. It was normal to them. Now they realize how addictive it can be. So you've got to really help them now before they get to a place where maybe they're out of control. We don't want that.
Yeah, and again, it's all about balance. It's all about coming together, get the family involved, bring the family unit together.
Be an example.
And, and have fun with it.
Yeah.
So I know we went over our time a little bit, but this was fun. It was a lot of fun. And I am going to announce next Tuesday, because you know we go live every Tuesday at 4:30. Next Tuesday, now that we're talking about sugar and sweets and all that, we are going live at our house where we're going to do some birthday baking. My birthday next week. So join us because we're actually going to be baking some really delicious, healthy treats. I'm super excited about that.
Yes, it's going to be fabulous.
After that, on the 21st, we'll talk about self-care isn't selfish. We can never hear enough about that. So often we put our self-care on the back burner and it's enough of that. And it's but it's also learning what is self-care. What does that mean?
When I do my self-care, it helps everyone around me.
Yes.
By me doing my self-care.
Yeah.
Yeah. It really does. It's amazing.
When we take care of ourselves, we can help others. Liz, I love all these tips. Thank you. Oh, thank you so much. I appreciate it. I'm so glad,
Liz,
you were here and you joined us. And I'm glad this was good information. And I know we don't always talk about the kids' topics, but we thought was kids going back to school. And I know parents are wondering and curious and wondering what they could do for their kids, do for themselves. So very excited about that. Thank you, everybody, who joined us live, and for those of you watching us recorded, we really appreciate the support. We're here to talk about topics that are important to you. So if there's anything that you want us to talk about, shoot us over an email. You can write down below, share any place. We'd love to hear from you. Have a fantastic evening. I'm gonna go home and make some dinner. Bye, everybody.
Bye, guys. Have a great week.